Welcome to Rockin' the Country again, guys. I'm Don, and today I'm going to be reviewing a song that hits home for a few reasons, but it's the band Perry's If I Die Young, and maybe you've heard it before. It's got the most views of any video that I've reviewed. It's got over 220 million views on the various YouTube uploads, which is more than Chris Stapleton's. That's splitting hairs because they're both phenomenal songs and artists. This song came out on their self-titled album. It was just titled The Band Perry in 2010 on Republic Nashville. They've since switched labels, which isn't all that important, but this is like a country blues song. I mean, there's not even like a genre for this, in my opinion. It's such a unique song. The band Perry is comprised of three family members, two brothers and Kim Perry, who I've always had a crush on. Well, not for the 4 years or so that she was married, but because you got to back off, you know what I mean? But anyway, these guys have won a lot of awards for, you know, duets, for songs. They've had a lot of number one hits. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead now and review this song. If you haven't heard it before, you'll see what I'm talking about. This is a seriously hard-hitting song, it's even got some uplifting elements to it. It's not like Copperhead Road, where it's like, it's just sort of like got that tone. So here we go with the band Perry's If I Die Young. There we go. Yeah, I always got to do this. There we go.
If I die young, bury me in sand, lay me down on a bed of roses, sink me in the river at dawn.
Oh yeah, Kim Perry wrote this too. So it shows her depth of inspiration, if you will.
Send me away with the words of a love song.
Before we get back to the chorus again, the sharp knife of a short life. That's brilliant. That's just when you work with words and you hit on something, there's so many options. I mean, when you're working with words, virtually an infinite number. And to capture what it's like for a mother to bury her baby, she's not even gray, which means the mother is still young, and she buries her baby. It's hard enough, even if you were 85, to bury a child, but I've known two people who lost their babies, their girls, and it's still, I mean, to this day, I mean, decades later, it just, anyway, Kim nailed it, the band nailed it. Here we go back.
Short life away.
just something here too. She's covering a few bases. She's not only covering, as I understand the song, of course, the mother who had to bury her baby. And a baby could be a 40-year-old. It doesn't matter. I mean, you give birth to somebody, they're always your baby. But then there's a boy here in town who said he'd love me forever. And then I'm assuming this is told from the first person where she died and he's left heartbroken and bereft. Okay, here we go back.
So put on your best, boys, and I'll wear my pearls. What I never did is done. A penny for my thoughts, oh no, I'll sell them for a dollar. They're worth so much more after I'm a goner. And maybe then you'll hear the words I've been singing. Funny when you're dead how people start listening.
That is true. After you die, then people look back on your words or your artwork or anything.
If I die young, bury me in satin, lay me down on a bed of roses, sink me in the river at dawn, send me away with the words of a love song. Up above, the ballad of a dove, go with peace and love, gather up your tears, keep them in your pocket, save them for a time.
Wow, that song is an experience, especially if you know somebody who maybe lost somebody. But even if you're just a mom or dad, you can understand this. Yeah, I mean, that song is a journey. I mean, just the way she sings, the mandolin in the background. I mean, that's rare. That's like Copperhead Road coming in with bagpipes. The mandolin in this song just sort of sets like sort of like almost like a happy little tone. And yet the subject matter is so brutal, so painful. So I give every song a rating on a scale of 1 to 10. And this song, I'm giving, it's definitely over a 9. I'm giving this song a 9.2. And this might only be the third song, maybe the second one that I've given over a 9. No. This is the third one. Tennessee Whiskey by Chris Stapleton, Copperhead Road by Steve Earle, and this one. Just, it's a journey, this song. And the instrumentation, there's irony in there where there's sort of like a happiness to it. But, and then it's like told from the first person, it seems, like the person who had died. It's tough to pull off that kind of thing where, like, you're dead. You can't really talk. But anyway, so you interpret it as you will. That's the band Perry's If I Die Young. And hit the subscribe button if you would. That's always a plus for me. And the like button if you would. Leave a comment, too. Leave a suggestion. I'll get to them. I read the comments. So there you go, guys. There's If I Die Young by the band Perry. Have a great day and keep rocking the country.